Supreme Master Ching Hai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For free of charge guidance, please visit www.godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
Olivia, huh? You just came?
Just arrived today.
Just arrived today. Hey, how's everybody? Snowflakes and chocolate. You all good?
Yes.
Newcomer, yeah?
Yes.
You new. So yesterday, did you enjoy the cakes and the love, yeah? I have some more today.
Wow.
Is it okay for you to be able to find food nowadays? Vegetarian food? I mean vegan? Easy? How? You go Chinese shop buy, right? In Chinese shop we have also, or in bio shop we have all kind of, they have all kind of things, yeah? If in your country, in your area, you have a Chinese shop for selling food, then you can find some in there. Maybe not that perfect, not natural, but yeah, but you can have it. Yes, we can?
Yes.
So, where are you from, brother?
Hungary.
Hungary, and the one behind you?
England.
England, huh? I haven't seen you before. New one, huh? How new?
About a year.
1 year? Oh, baby, huh? Okay, give me some cakes. That's what we came for, yeah. I cannot throw, so maybe I throw some. Only, yeah? Oh, you already had yesterday, you eat in my kitchen, and now you clap your hand like you haven't got anything. If you are too far, you can come here and get some. You want?
Yes.
Yeah, come here. Yeah. Oh, the. How is your food today?
Good.
Rice soup, right?
Yes.
Salad and rice soup. And in the morning? Huh?
Soup.
Same soup?
Different.
Different. Which one better, the morning or the afternoon?
Both very good.
Ah, because I only have some rice soup, so I don't know the other one. What is the other one?
With pasta and vegetables.
Ah, yum. Come here, baby. Anyone who want to come here? All the Westerners, come here. Yeah. Welcome home. Welcome home, welcome home. Hey, Mike. How are you doing, Mike?
Very good.
All of you here?
Almost.
The one who stay in SMG. Okay. The new people, please come here. A new one come here, huh? New one. Oh, so many new one. Thank you, love, for coming. Are you sure?
Yes.
Come today?
Yes.
Oh, man. And I thought you were all downstairs.
No.
Eh? You got it all? Oh, here you are. Come before they squeeze you when you got nothing. Come here. Chocolate. Can you? You're welcome, love. Okay, anybody else? How about two line? Yeah?
Yes.
Quicker, yeah? Two line, yeah? Yeah. Only the new one, okay? Two line. Two line and go back. Two line, go back, quick, quick, quick. Oh my God. Oh. Incredible. Ah, what do you expect? There. Yeah, that's good also like that. Yes. Yeah. Oh, that MTV, are you here, yeah? Good. I'll talk to you later. Jaima. Oh my God. 我看到他只有两岁而已，吵着要看师傅。
他现在这么高。
Oh my God. Yeah, okay. We put it up here. Yeah, two of you. Oh, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, chưa?
Yeah.
Okay, chưa? I love you. Okay, yeah. Love you. I love you so. Every day more. I love from God. Forever so. Nah, have a good look at your mama. Oh, so many upstairs, I can't believe it. I thought they were downstairs. So I talk so long downstairs because they're new people. How are you? If you go to China, they love you. Means has a, you know, a lot of... Yeah. Oh, China is special. China is special. Because, you know, when people around, I think you have a lot of merit. Yeah. I mean, you bring good luck and all that. Yeah. Chinese people, yeah, they believe that. I'm trying, but I can't get anywhere. Trying. You know, there is a picture somewhere. No, it's not here. You know, they make my face look like a pancake, nah? Puff up like a pancake. Oh, they love this photo. It sells a lot. The Chinese people. Yo fu wao. You understand? Sorry if some...
The pictures are always beautiful.
Yeah, I know, but the one, the big pop-up, they love. Sells a lot, you know. Yeah. The one that I look, you know, very prosperous and, you know, generous, oh, they love it. Love you. Love you guys. Did you all have good translation? Yeah? Yeah? Yeah, love you. I love very much. Mucho amoro. Ah, a lot of SMTV here, huh? Okay, how are you? You look like an adventurer, go to the jungle or something. Finito?
Finito.
Oh, wonderful. Getting angry, you know. Okay, the rest you bring. Love, 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 love. Give it to them. And how you practice 1 year? How is your practice?
Some days better than others.
Of course, that's normal. The world doesn't give us always the peace to meditate, no? Yeah. Okay. I have some more cakes today, guys. Wow. Anybody want to go there and taste it?
Yeah.
Oh, who wants it? Ah. No, too many. My kitchen is this big. And what's your name?
Charles.
Charles, like Prince Charles? Ah. Okay. A lot of Charles in England anyway, huh? But not all are Prince. Yeah. They are taken anyway, huh? You happy with the soup?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Wonderful.
Wonderful?
Okay.
Easier to digest? Yeah, and meditate better or not? Tell me the truth.
Yeah.
Yeah? Especially in hot weather, hey?
Yes.
These 2 months, the weather is very reliable, but it's warm. So we should eat a little easy to digest. But I see them cook the soup very thick, no? That's a cheat. That's not soup, that's like pudding. Salty pudding, no? Hey, kitchen! How come you cook the soup so thick? That's a pudding, there's no soup. They like it like that? You like it more soupy or...? No? Who like more soupy? Raise hand. Oh, minority. Okay. They call it pudding, not soup. Soup is not. Soup means has a little, you know, a soupy taste. It has water, né? You go, soup! That's why they call soup. Never mind. If you enjoy, it's okay. How long you guys stay?
7 days.
7 days, huh? Okay. You don't want to stay longer? You like me only 1 week?
No, we do want to, but we have to work.
Have worked there a lot, huh? Yeah, of course. A lot, huh? Always, huh? Even if we don't have SMTV anymore, we still have a lot of work. You're sort of a person. Oh, okay. No more volunteer? Anybody volunteer to go do SMTV work again? And everybody else just go to be resident, huh? Enjoy, huh? Sleeping, huh? Even I still have to work, you know? When I do retreat, means I don't go in the public, yeah? I don't go out. Not when I don't have to, yeah? If I have to go check up the teeth and all that, of course I have to go, yeah? But I don't go shopping or sightseeing and all that stuff, and I don't go out, disco or anything, yeah? I dance with wolf, dogs, dancing with dogs at home. Exercise, you know, go in the yard, and they jump around, and I also jump about. Yeah, that's my exercise. And in the morning, I brush my teeth, that's my exercise. Last time, evening, exercise, yeah. Otherwise, to sit all day also okay, if you can, huh? If not, we can work like half a time, yeah? Like work a few hours a day, and then the rest meditate. Some people cannot meditate long. Even if they have a lot of time, they don't meditate that much. And sometimes the more time you have, the less work you do. You just think, oh, I meditate later. Yeah, or I go out now, or I watch TV. Too much freedom, and it's difficult to have discipline, yes? So some people prefer to work a little bit, yeah, a few hours a day, and then meditate, and it's also very good, depends. Anybody who can sit all day, 24 hours, don't move, right hand? No? Don't have? No? How about a new resident, huh? From SMTV, did you sit a lot? Where? From Florida Center and all that? Are you not here?
I'm not here, Master.
Not here. And meditate, huh? Do they really meditate? Did they tell you?
Yes, Master.
They meditate all day?
Not all day.
I mean, a lot?
Yes.
Really? Any Buddha has been born? Don't know. Okay, it's good. Nice to see you. Just the house is small, so not enough room to sit for all of you. Today not too bad, huh? Last time when I woke up, oh, it's like a heat wave, you know, hit your face. But today it's not too bad. And how about you? Do you feel too hot there? Really? Oh, you're really good. Really? You don't feel hot? You can meditate? Oh, you better than me. I feel this is too soft, you know. At home, you know, wherever my home can be, if I have a bed, it would be like, if I can make it, you know, like a wood plank, a piece of wood made, and then there's some leg underneath, a little bit higher so the dog can go under, and I'm on top. And it's hard, it should be hard, and I have just like this kind of mattress. But it's not real mattress, it's those that they buy to put it on this lounge chair on the beach. Yeah, so they're very thin. Sit better, yeah. Or lay down also better. It's too soft, I never like soft things, too soft. Sit like you don't have support for your spine. Okay, are you guys all right, huh? My God, I admire you, you're so good. You okay, Charles? Maybe tired, huh? Yeah, I will leave soon, disappear, and then you can meditate. Yeah? No? You not fed up with me?
No!
Every time, look, same face. My face must be very, very attractive to you, huh? I think you all have the same taste, right? It's funny, because the Chinese would have liked me a little bit, you know, like a moon face, and here a little bit more developed. I try. I eat all kinds of things, but I cannot be like you. I think it's a gene, huh? It's a gene. It's not how much you eat, huh? Oh, well, what can I do for you? Do you want to tell me something, new people? Ask question? Yes?
Master, you were asking sisters here just before about if it's easy to buy vegan food in my hometown. Yeah. I come from Montreal, Quebec, Canada. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I can tell you it's very easy to find, even in Western supermarkets, wow, vegan food.
Wonderful.
Yeah, made in either in Quebec or in Vancouver.
Ah, you speak Quebecois there?
Yeah? Yes, Francais, Quebecois.
When I was in your country, I can't understand a thing. I have some friends, you know, from Quebec. Originally, they just came to fix something in the house. And then we became friends. And they talked, and I said, what are you saying? It's not English, is it? He said, no, it's French. I said, French? I asked them, is it French? And they told me, it's Quebecois. Yeah. It's like French, but it's like Swiss French. Also difficult. Like Swiss German. Oh, they say they speak German in Switzerland. A part of Swiss. I understand nothing. And they speak French. They are also difficult to understand. So I'm glad for you. Hmm? What kind of food can you find there in England? Wow, it's heaven in England, huh? A lot of food.
Yeah, in Montreal, it's really easy. Before, I remember when I just started being initiated and being vegan, it's really hard. And sometimes if I forget to bring my own lunch from home, my lunch would be some carrots and some salad.
Oh, not bad.
My colleague would say, oh, you're missing out a lot, da-da-da-da-da. Oh,
you now, look good.
Now I can go to supermarkets and they have vegan salamis, and I have vegan very organic bread, and I have vegan spread. So they're like, wow, what's this? What's this you're eating? You're not turning back to non-vegan?
Meat, yeah.
I said, no, never.
Yeah, it looks real. I look like the meat thing.
And they don't trust me. They taste it and they say, this is really good. I'm going to have my kids try it.
Yeah? Wonderful. You can bring the package and so they can look at the ingredients as well.
Yes.
Yeah, because they, nowadays they make all kind of things. It look like the meat stuff and tastes better even, yeah? I don't know why people still want to eat meat. You done, love? Somebody want to talk behind you.
Hi, Master.
Hi.
I'm come from the same country as the sister.
Same
from,
country?
Yeah, in Ontario, Canada.
Canada.
And yeah, for the food, we can buy even vegan cheese.
Yeah.
It's really like a real cheese.
Yeah, I have it in my house. Yes.
Yeah, I bake some a vegan lasagna
mm-hmm.
and bring to my neighbor, my workplace.
Mm-hmm.
They love it so much. And my boss say she, because of that, she wants to be one day as a vegan to mm-hmm. start with.
Yeah.
Yeah, so they really enjoy it, and they know the fats, it's healthy.
Good.
You know, I share with my working team,
yeah.
with all the vegetarian, the vegan healthy fat,
mm.
so and the environmental, and also I become, because of that,
yes.
I become a environmental sustainability development committee mm. in my workplace.
Whoa,
yeah, so,
big shot.
They just accept a vegan diet as green diet as part of their project.
Yeah.
So yeah, we do a lot of like put booth to send out the information at my workplace.
Good.
Yeah. So and also my daughter she's a vegan vegetarian baby since day one, and when she go to school. At the beginning, her friends are kind of curious, but they are very accepting for her diet and sometimes yeah. cheer her up.
So,
at a physical education, say, use your power of tofu. yeah.
Instead of kung fu, tofu, huh? Everybody eat tofu and healthy. Okay. Listen, you guys, if you have long lecture, stretch it, yeah? Stretch, don't care, okay? Nobody here is your home. Yeah, like that is good, I don't care, okay? You'll be relaxing. Until when you go out in the garden, it's cooler and more natural air, yeah? Okay.
I have some good news from Australia.
Wow.
I don't know whether you've heard this yet.
No, not yet, mate.
Okay.
No.
The health body of the Australian government recently formally recognised that the vegan diet is a viable option for people to live a healthy life. So,
finally.
So that's in the nutritional guidelines.
Yeah.
So that's just come out. So that's
wow.
Yeah.
England also, the government recommend people to be more vegan now, mm-hmm. vegetarian vegan.
Yeah, they're more progressive than Australia, I think.
Yeah. Okay. Congratulations, Moit. Yeah. Good. And the new PM, okay?
Kevin Rudd, yes. He's been Prime Minister before and now he's Prime Minister again.
Yeah.
I don't know if there's much of a difference.
Yeah, shorter people. Political yeah. party is only about that, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4 people
yeah.
circulating. It's a recycle, huh?
Yeah.
But the last PM was very cool, no? She's nice.
I thought she was good too.
She's yeah. really cool. Mm. The first woman, she was very cool.
Mm. Yeah.
Maybe later more woman power, eh? Yeah.
I hope so.
It don't matter, man or woman, as long as they do a good job, serve the country well, and care about people's well-being, then it's good. Mm? But many women, they have more woman touch, you know? More motherly side and maybe more detailed care for people. Just my opinion. But it's funny, hey, it's a man world, hey? Even masters has been all men, you know, mostly men. If any woman master, then normally you don't hear of very, very less prominent. This is the first time we change it, to change history. They say there's Jesus has a prophecy about himself, you know, one of the magazines somewhere a long time ago. They say, I will come back, but as a woman, then nobody will recognize me. I just read it like that. Hmm? One magazine, I'm not sure. Hmm? Look, vegan, vegan children are very healthy. Look at these two of them, my sister. I look pretty, no? No, actually, it's a mother. We look like sisters. Because she looks so young. I was thinking, really, sister, just now. No, sister. Oh, and all the young, you know, girls are beautiful, huh? Yeah. Why? If you go to school like that, everybody think they want to be vegan because you are so beautiful and handsome, huh? Yeah, nice looking. Yeah, I would like to see children grow up like this, huh? Look at that, huh? Beautiful. And the mother just look like sister. Look at that, the both of them. So young, eh? Yeah. Okay. Right. Any more good news?
Master, I would like to share good news. You might know this already. Earlier, Master was talking about how important it is that a leader or the government should do what is right. Mm. As Master knows, since Obama became a president, Michelle Obama has been putting effort to educate citizens about the value of having plant-based diet. Mm. In America, USA now is not the fattest country in the world now.
It's not?
Yeah. I just read the news.
They lose their status as
That's
the,
right. So it's a good news.
As the giant of the planet?
Well, right now...
Congratulations.
Truly. Thank you, Master.
So who is the fattest on the planet now?
I'm afraid to say that Mexico right now is the fattest country.
Mexico is the fattest now? Oh, yeah. What a shame.
Yeah, I just read the news the other day.
How can it be? They eat only beans.
Maybe too much cheese. Maybe.
Too much cheese?
Yeah.
Oh, nowadays they eat a lot of meat too, huh?
Yeah.
Pity. Yeah, really? But I haven't seen a fat Mexican.
I just read that last week.
Hey, amigo, stand up. I have a look at you. He's not fat. Okay. The Mexicans I know are not fat. Maybe because just the disciple, you know? Your brother and sister initiate, so.
True.
Okay. Yeah. Really? The Mexicans are the fattest on the planet now? Maybe because their statues are not tall. So if they put on a little weight, then it's very obvious. That's why.
Yeah, it'll make difference, for sure.
If he's tall like Olivia or... Charles there, then if he put on more weight, don't look too much, huh? Yeah. Okay. Well, congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. Another good news is that in our clinic, we have special service in helping people to lose weight and quit smoking.
Wow.
So,
thanks to... Is that special clinic or something?
Chiropractic acupuncture clinic.
Uh-huh.
And we also have herbal therapy, so... We have a special herbal formula now that can help people to cut down the craving for junk food and eliminate excessive fluid and fat level. So,
oh, wonderful.
Yeah, thank you.
Any successful?
So far, people have been responding well. We have a lot of patients are taking that now, so they are responding well.
So where do go all these kilos?
Basically, the herbal medicine can help to speed up metabolism.
Yeah, it's true, huh?
Yeah, truly. And then help the digestive system to work better.
Oh, it's good, huh?
Truly.
Yeah, I think it's true. You know, the Vietnamese, they eat a lot of herbs, you know.
Right, right.
And then you hardly see any fat Vietnamese.
Truly.
And yeah. The Indian people, they also eat a lot of herb or spice.
Right, right.
They're also less fattening people, right?
Yeah. Some herbs are very effective in helping the digestive system to function better. Yeah. So that's why it works.
And the Chinese, they also eat a lot of vegetable, you know?
True.
Therefore, even though they like chubby, but not many fat Chinese, right?
Not many.
No. They love it. They love to have a fat face and round body and all that because they think that means they have a lot of blessing and... They can bring luck to whoever marry them or something like that. In the old time, the husband always look for chubby face. A married, you know, moon face, they call it, yeah. They still love, you know, round people. Me, I'm not very welcome in China if I go there. So, you know, I mean, I'm not... I don't belong to the unlucky bringer, but I don't belong to the lucky bringer group either. You know, club, you know, I must be a little round, you know. Before, I have Chinese cameraman. Most of the picture they took, and most of the video, they make me look like, In the gallery, there's one picture of me. Oh, you won't recognize it. Double my size. really. I saw it, right? Some of you saw it, no? Yeah, Michelle, huh? Yeah. So big, and even mouth big or so, you know, lips. I have thin lips, but over there, my lips look very prominent, you know? Such a funny. Yeah, I really look like that. I don't know how he does it. There's one guy, he especially loves my face to look chubby, so every time I have to tell him, tune it down. And then he keep telling me, oh, it's not master, it's just the TV. It's just a screen and make it look like that. It's not like that. So when I have the video, I believe him. I thought it's just a screen that make me look fat there. But when the video come out, I really look fat. It's not the screen, it's really the way he put the angle or something, you know? Yeah, really. So you can see in the same period of time, sometimes I look like this in the video or the photo, and sometimes I look like that. Mm? Same, just a couple of days apart. It's funny, huh? The camera, they told me the camera I don't like, but it does. I have experience with camera. Liar! Liar. Oh, any more good news somewhere? Thank you for your good news. Yeah. Good news always make people happy, yeah? Come here, just forget about your trouble. Tell only good news. Positive energy, yeah? Yeah. Yes.
Hi, Master.
Hi.
I'm from Oregon Center.
Mm-hmm.
And in Oregon, Portland is the biggest city. It's the biggest vegan-friendly in the United States.
Oh, really?
Yes. And then second is Seattle, and the third one is San Francisco.
Oh, thanks to you guys. Mm-hmm.
And in Oregon, the brother and sister, we have the first one is a vegan restaurant, it's the Vegetarian House. And second one is the Sweet Lemon.
Mm-hmm.
And then third one is the Loving Heart.
Mm-hmm.
And also there's also many different outside people have the vegan restaurant.
Wow.
And then in Portland, Oregon, every year is an annual event. It's called the Portland Veg Fest.
Mm-hmm.
And they will have in September 2 days. And they sample all, they have a hundred of simple food, just everything is a vegan. Yeah. So you only pay fee about $5 go into, and they can eat all day long to sample different products. It's just wonderful.
Tell us how to do it here.
And this is what event is like every year, Northwest Veg Society put it out, and our associate member has been participate this event for last past 5, 6, 7 years that I know.
Mm.
And every year the event, they all invite the key speaker like Dr. Esselstein, the Folk Overnight, and then Dr. Greger.
Mm-hmm.
And each year they have one of these keynote speaker. Attracts so many people. And last year, with 2 days event, they have attract about 6,000-7,000 people just to come into that.
I should change my profession. Become a doctor and go there. I am a doctor, but not a physician. Doctor philosophy, what to do with it? Can't eat, can't cure people. Then?
Sweet Lemon Restaurant.
Do you have such thing as Sweet Lemon?
It's Fong's restaurant.
What a name, huh?
Yeah. And then her business is busy all the time.
Oh.
Yeah.
Fong, huh? Busy, rich, huh? You always look so young, like I know you 20 years ago. My God. Ah, very good. Yeah. Congratulations. Okay. And thank you for your effort. You're saving the world. Yeah. Saving lives. Good. Good job.
Master, last month I actually went travel in UK, in London area, and naturally I go to the website to search for a vegan restaurant. Mm. And I found out that so many websites actually highly recommend our Loving Heart in London.
Really?
The non-disciple people highly recommend it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and the second good news that I want to share is I live in the around the border of New Jersey and New York, and now we have a lot more vegan restaurants, and also we have a chain Whole Foods supermarket. Mm. We can find not only the vegan product, but also the organic vegan. Mm. And also I started to find out like vegan salon, vegan nail polish, the vegan spa.
Yeah. Vegan nail polish?
Yeah. It's very interesting. They have it in UK also.
Cool. Yeah. Yeah. I know they have vegan makeup nowadays. Vegan makeup, vegan beauty care. Very nice and really working. Mm. Feel better than using the other with chemical stuff. Feel lighter and it's just feel nicer. Feel more natural and light. Yeah, ma'am.
I just remember in Poland, last couple of years, there's another restaurant. It's called Veggie Grill. And okay, it's so popular. So in Oregon, we have the three Veggie Grill. Wow. And that is attract most for the local people.
Wow, why don't
people.
We also make a Loving Hood Grill, vegan grill? Yes.
Okay.
There's a chain nowadays, you know. Not
yeah,
much.
In California, they're coming out from the
Yeah, that's good.
And they are going to open, I guess, two or three in Seattle, too.
Good, good. If your restaurant can also make grill. if you cannot make Loving Hood restaurant, you can make simple like that, you know? Like you make like a buffet and cook as they go, and then people go and serve it themselves. Fresh, but also cheaper. Mm-hmm. You don't have to cover the table or anything, make a lot of extra work for nothing, yeah. There are a lot of ideas you can also incorporate into Loving Hood, né? Or Loving Cafe or whatever, yeah. Doesn't always have to be Loving Hood style, yeah. But Loving Hood also very cheap, right? Yeah. Hmm. Okay, congratulations. And thanks to all of you for working hard. Any more? One. One and a half, two, okay.
Just remember during the Veggie Festival, we hang up some of those vegan restaurants, hang up menu, and this lady saw the Loving Heart, and she said, wow, my goodness, I was in Mongolia, and the Loving Heart is the only place I can eat. And now I'm here in Oregon, United States, and Loving Heart is also here. And she was so happy.
Yes, and we become very famous now. Eh?
Yes.
Like a chain restaurants. Uh-huh. And everybody love it. Some people don't open restaurants. They open like Loving Hood Cafe, Loving Hood Express also. Wow, business very well. Like in Brussels. They have only very small restaurant, like two or three tables. But only two or three sisters work there, you know, together. And they work so good, you know, business is so good. So small, but they earn a lot of income, even though they sell very cheap. Three tables, something like that. But they make very good food, really quality food. So important is taste good, eh? Not just pray for master blessing and then to dish out anything. Not fair.
I just think it's really important to eat the healthiest you can if you know what's healthiest for you. It's obviously a non-animal diet, so.
If you love animals, the first thing you should do is stop eating them, not the last thing.
You know, the old paradigm, we are what we eat. I stopped eating meat 7 years ago. It felt really good. You should try exploring more vegetarian options too.
Shakyamuni Buddha, Jesus Christ, St. Francis of Assisi, Leonardo da Vinci, Shania Twain, Leo Tolstoy, Albert Einstein, Alicia Silverstone, Tobey Maguire, Joaquin Phoenix, Pamela Anderson. What do these distinguished people of the past and present have in common? They represent the circle of vegetarian and vegan elite, and some of the most gifted and accomplished people in the world.
The biggest impact that we can have on our planet is through our food choices and what we have on our plate.
There's no question that the number one contributor to climate change is livestock production. The quickest way to make an effect is to immediately start on a vegan diet. It also happens to be delicious and good for your health, so it's a win-win.
One of the reasons I became vegan is the golden rule. You know, the idea of doing unto others as you would have them do unto you. The best way to increase my happiness and also hopefully increase the happiness of others is actually be concerned for the well-being of other people and other animals. So that's a big part of my veganism as well.
They are some of the countless noble examples of compassion and wisdom. So keep in good company with the Noble Circle of Vegetarian and Vegan Elite. And the list goes on. Please visit www.suprememastertv.com/VE for further club list and info. Choose veggie and join the club.
Master, I want to share a vegan cheesy story. It's back in Montreal. We started doing vegan cooking workshop because we are not a lot, so we don't have enough resources to open Loving Hut or something, but we still want to do something. So starting last summer, we were inviting people and coming for a free cooking workshop. At the beginning, there were 30 people registered and only 15 people showed up. But we persevere, and now we have maybe 60, 65 people registered, and always 40, 45 people come up, and they will bring extra friends to learn. But the cheesy story side is because I think about this all the time, so sometimes maybe I not ignore, but maybe let aside my husband. And when I'm angry, I'm not as patient. Mm. Just before you ask, are we tired of you? Do we still love you? Mm. When sometimes we think that we don't think about it all the time, mm. but at a time like this, it's my mother who's not an initiate would tell me, hey, Victoria, what your master would do. And then I'd be like, no, I'm not a good example. And I will sit down and rethink my character and oh. redo things properly and love you even more. Because you are always so generous. And at the same time, you make sure that everybody's feeling are taken care of. It's not just one thing. It's everything needs to be taken care of. And that's my cheesy story.
You don't know I'm at home. Oh, okay, I'm glad that you benefit, yeah, from whatever I have to offer. Hmm? It's not easy to take care of big family, yeah, of course, because different characters, different egos, different karmic background, different present fixed karma background, all kind of things, yeah. But I'm so glad that we are just like a family, a good family, you know, I mean, majority speaking, we are a good family. Like we can trust each other and we can love each other naturally. Everybody come from different country, anywhere, anytime, and just feel like at home. Mm. I'm so glad about that. Yeah. Don't you think so? It's good, huh? You just feel at home, at ease with each other. Like here, you can relax and feel peace. Yeah. You have not to worry about anybody make trouble for you or cheat you or do something bad to you at all, ever. Yes, yeah. Feel like one, eh? Most of the time, and this is good, yes. Okay, yeah. And so your mother always used me to discipline you.
It seems everything else is not working as properly as yeah. before.
So I'm like the whip, huh?
Well, she knows I would respect your words more than anything else. So
oh,
when she tries everything else and it doesn't work, and then she would say, "What would your master do?" Yes, mother, I'm sorry.
Yes, mom, aye, mom. Wow, my God, and is she not initiate, right?
She's not initiate.
Yeah,
she,
but she can
vegetarian.
Use me all right. Yeah. Yeah. Imagine that.
Because she says maybe I don't show as much affection or show as much attention to my husband as she wanted, because mm-hmm. the traditional way of husband and wife.
Mm-hmm.
But she sees me that I go to group meditation diligently. When there's cooking workshop, I jump up and mm-hmm. then I do all sorts of things, and I'm very happy and I'm always like 200% powered.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess that's why she thinks, okay, if I can tell you the normal, mundane way, then mm-hmm. let's go to the supreme way.
Okay. I'm glad your mother is happy about you. Hmm? All right. Anything else? 2.5? Immediately. Whenever I say I'm going, and then I always... A lot of hands growing.
Master, I just want to say thank you so much for everything you did to us.
What did I do?
Everything. It's I don't know how to say it.
How do you know what I do? You have seen me only one or twice a year.
I'm a kind of pretty sensitive person, and I have a lot of things going on before in my life, and it's so much miracle happened in my life, and even at my most difficult time when I left my husband, you arranged everything, you make me strong, and I never can imagine without you I can go through all those. And even physically, I have a heart condition. And at the time, I was thinking that if I die, I would die as a free spirit. And so I still keep going. And one day morning when I get up, all those kind of heart condition, it's gone, it's clear. It's like I just feel I can breathe so freely. Before I my heart like a beeping twice, skip one, beeping twice.
Yeah, irregular.
Yeah, and I feel very hard to breathe anytime. I can't run well. But one morning I wake up, it's all gone. It's clear like a clear sky.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. And also from my childhood, I was tomboyish. So I do a lot of goofy stuff. It's your miracle. I can raise my daughter like that, and she's like my sister now, and I learn a great deal from her. And she really, sometimes when I not behave like a mother, and she will remind me that you, and it's like a mirror to calm me down and look more straight. And Master, I don't know how to say thank you to you. And
okay, you're welcome.
And in my workplace, I designed a few pictures, put on my cubicle, and my coworkers pass by. They always stop and ask who she is, and I say it's my spiritual master, and they say, oh, she's so beautiful, and I say, wait, if you see her in person,
no.
you don't know how to. Thank you. You don't know how she beautiful, how beautiful she is, so great, graceful and so loving, and the energy and so romantic. I don't know how we deserve you. Really, your music, your poetry. I from when I was very young, I love poetry, but your poetry, it's really. I don't put words as best because other people can compare with you, so I don't use the best, but it touches my heart so and you with the energy inside, and not only the wording is beautiful, powerful, but the energy, and when I read your book, often crying. And thank you so much.
You're welcome.
I designed a card for you. May I bring to you?
I just have a look.
Okay, thank you.
But I cannot accept everything. I don't have room. I run around. I can't carry all the time. I can hardly carry a clothes, or I just wear what they buy for me here. Which one? Poem or is it card?
That is for you.
Ah.
It's from my photographer.
Of course, you choose the best photo that day.
So I designed.
Thank you.
That's
wow.
For your Mother's Day, and because anytime you want.
I don't have such a picture like that. I don't remember I have a photo like that. Do I?
You do. I downloaded from website.
Oh, really?
And then.
Yeah. She's really beautiful here, yeah. I don't know her, I don't recognize.
I sent you and because you are in Richie, I can give to you.
Thank you very much. I keep, okay? Thanks a lot. You still have a copy, right?
Yes,
you have.
Sir.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Thank you
That's
so
fine,
sure.
That's fine.
Okay,
I'll keep that one, it's better, so it don't go bad. Yeah, okay.
Thank you, Master.
Thank you to you. Gracias. Vielen Dank. Sehr, sehr. Come on. Merci. Very nice. If I see her like this, I also think she's beautiful. Special effect, Olivia. Olivia, nobody can look like this. Oh, they're so beautiful, huh? I don't recognize her. Nice, huh? I don't remember. I have such photo. They take all kind of photo and then they hide them from me. I never know. Oh, sorry. It's the first time I saw a photo like that from me. Isn't it very nice, huh? It looks so holy, huh? Where is it so beautiful? They even put some halo on, on my face, on my head. Okay. Just he choose the best picture and say, I'm beautiful, of course. Anybody can look beautiful if they're the photographer make you.
No, every picture is beautiful.
Oh, they make
and
it
different as well. Different,
yeah, I told you, some is skinny, some...
They're all beautiful.
Beautiful. All right, thank you, love. Thanks for your love. Thank you, Master. Your love and your faith and your divine way of life would help you to overcome many things. It doesn't have to be me, okay? But the Master Power always helps the one who already helps himself. Yeah? If you live right, yeah, you think right and you do things right, then your life will be always right. Okay? Yes, we have a lot of tests and tribulation, but if we know our goal and discipline, then it's easier to live. Yeah? Simple. Not just heart disease, anything else can leave you. Because they have nowhere to cling onto your body. It's good. Congratulations, congratulations.
I love you so much.
Love you. Two and three quarter. Let's go. Yeah, no, the Choco, you wait all this time? Just one quarter left.
Hey, Master.
Hi.
How are you today?
I'm good. You can see. Okay. I'm beautiful. And how are you?
I'm good yeah? too. Thank you for everything, Master.
You're welcome.
I have a question, actually. I would like to ask a question about the number 12. Is the number 12 have some kind of special meaning? Of course, I noticed that the clock have 12 portions.
Mm-hmm.
The calendar have
12 months.
Yeah. Even the astrologic use
12
zodiac signs.
Yes.
12 zodiac signs.
Uh-huh.
And even the great master as Jesus have 12 disciples.
Oh.
So
I don't have 12. Well, I have 12 million, but no, 12 main disciples, yes. Okay, just like maybe 12 residents, yeah? Long term. Okay. Yeah, so why you want to ask me?
I would like to know if 12 have a special meaning on the universe, why they choose 12 instead of choose another number?
The Chinese people, they also believe that 12, you know, like 6 and 6. So if you give somebody a gift of money, you give like 66, yeah, or six and six, or just something like that, yeah, 120. I just do the same. I hope that person who get it become lucky. If not, no harm. He has 120 euros for me. No? Evidently, he's lucky, no? Okay, love, I really don't know. I did not go into the detail like that. But in Vietnam, we have a very nice fairy story, you know, about the animals.
Okay.
Yeah, that's why in Vietnam, we also have 12 zodiac sign for each person. Yeah, for one person, it's one sign. Like the rat and the buffalo, the tiger, the rabbit or the cat. Same, rabbit in China, they call rabbit, Vietnam called cat. And the dragon, yeah? And then the snake, and then the horse, and the monkey, and then the quack quack, you know, the chicken.
Tiger.
Chicken. And then the goat, yeah? The goat before the monkey. And then the monkey, and then the chicken, and then the dog, wow, 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 and then the pig. Yeah. Whew. Yeah, maybe I have to do research into that, but I just had some more important thing to do, so.
Okay.
Yeah, I didn't do it, but thank you for asking. I will look into it, see why.
Okay? Thank you, Master.
If it's so important to you, I will look into it. I never care what number, you know. But the Buddha has also the 12 affinities, you know, like that, 6 perfection. He also used a lot of number. I guess all these people before, you know, they're mathematicians, huh? The masters, they're mathematicians. They like number a lot. I did not think much about it, yes. My major subject in school is not math. Yeah, it's philosophy. Yeah, so. Okay. Yeah, it's interesting, eh? How come only 12, 12, 12 all the time? Why not 11? not 13, huh? Yeah. Interesting. And some people say number 7 is lucky, you know, because God made the world in 7 days. And maybe that's why it's a mess like this. You know? Good things take time, they say. God is too hurry, you know. 7 days, how you make it? Yeah. I could have asked him to make a little more perfection of me, you know. No, he's in a hurry. I don't know where does he go that he's so hurry like this. What else he want to do after? That he have to press everything in 7 days. Where does he go? What would he want to do after that? He has infinity. Why only 7 days? This is really some question we go and ask this guy. What can you do in 7 days? I mean, holiday, okay, vacation, honeymoon, but not the whole, make the whole creation in 7 days. If in a hurry, sometimes make mistake, you know. Okay, yeah. Number seven is lucky. Some people say number 6 is lucky. Some people say number 9, you know, all kind of things. Yeah? Okay? So what do you think why number 12 is? What do you think? Maybe you had idea.
Not really. It's why you're asking.
You don't know? Anybody have idea why? I'm not a mathematician. I never liked math. I don't like mathematics too much. Anybody who know? Yeah. A good luck? But why? Maybe you see, no. Yeah. One by one.
Maybe because there's 12 phases of the moon in 1 year. The moon goes from full to crescent back to full 12 times per year.
Yeah, maybe. But that's the moon calendar, they probably based on that. But even the Western calendar also 12 months. You see?
That's also partially lunar, right?
No, not really. They have different zodiac altogether. Yeah? Timing is different. The spring is different than the moon calendar.
I just think that if 6 is a lucky number, then double 6 is a
lucky
number.
But I don't know why 6 is lucky. I guess the Chinese believe it. They believe in the sound of the word. You see? Because sometimes, like you say positive, then you feel positive also. When you say something, oh, she's good, and then you have this impression of goodness. You say good, yeah. And if you say something not positive, then you also feel the effect of the not positive word. See what I mean? Yes. So in Chinese, maybe the sound of the 6 is liu, you know, liu. Liu just means very smoothly flowing. Eh? So liu means okay, it's flowing, everything smooth. I guess, is that so, the Chinese people?
Yes.
Yeah?
Makes sense?
That's what I was thinking, you know? Yes. So the Chinese, they use words carefully. And now they're using positive power now. This word is very famous now in China. It's become like a fashion now. Everybody talk, oh, positive power. Just now, the Chinese sister of yours reported downstairs. If you had translation, you understand.
Yes.
So, for example, they avoid the word that sounds something bad luck, you know, like si lou, huh? Si, it means si that sound like dead, similar to the word dead. Huh? So they don't like to live on the fourth floor, right? Yes. So if the house had 5 floors and they change the 4th floor into the 5th or the 6th floor instead, they don't say 4th floor. So you'll be difficult to find the 4th floor if you in China. They avoid that word, yeah? Sometimes like that. They avoid many words that doesn't sound like the lucky word. Similar sound, yeah? They like the red color, yeah? Because it says Hong. Hong means you develop, you prosper, understand? You become big, yeah? So they like the red color, and because of the word like that, yeah? And many things. Even they choose the fruits. Yeah, like in Vietnam, when New Year time, you're supposed to collect all the luck possible for the whole, for the first day of the year to spend the whole year round. So they choose carefully the fruit that they offer to heaven or to their ancestors. Like they choose the mango, yeah, and they choose a papaya, and they choose coconut, okay? Because the coconut in Vietnamese word is year, okay? And the papaya is du, yeah? And the mango is xoài, okay? So they the sound similar to say, oh, just enough to spend, you know? I mean, you will not be short of money. Year du xoài, yeah? Something like that, you know, very funny. Yeah, but maybe it has some psychological effect, you know? Because every word has a sound, silently or loudly. It carries some energy, no? Mm. Just like when you call somebody, oh, you are sane, or you're beautiful. Even though I know I'm not beautiful, but if you tell me I'm beautiful, I love it.
You are beautiful.
No, I mean the sound, you know? Yeah. And even though the most beautiful girl in the world, she has uncertainty somewhere. And if you tell her that, oh, your legs are short, your nose is too big, and she probably will feel sad for many days and really feel very bad conscious about her nose or her legs. Yeah, for many days, and she'll be unsure of her beauty. And she doesn't feel so good and happy as if you tell her, oh, you're beautiful. And even though she knows it's a lie, but she likes it still. Yeah, even then, you know what I mean? Yeah, it's true like that. The positive words have a positive energy to go with it. That's why we call God and everybody feel revere in the heart. Or Buddha, and you feel like benevolence. You know, the energy goes with it. If you call somebody bad, you know, bad name or tell them bad thing, the energy also bad. You know the Japanese, they make experience with even unspoken words.
With the water?
Yeah, with the water. They just wrote something positive on it, holy on it, or bad or evil on it. Then the water changed. The water changed accordingly. If it's holy and good, then the water is clear and nice, a beautiful formation. If they put some bad word on the glass of water, then the water become murky or bad or, you know, very ugly formation. Yeah, yeah, you know already, yeah? Maybe, I don't know why, number 12, probably start from China. Yeah, Liu Liu, you know? Because Chinese are so big, you know what I mean? China is always a big country, and Chinese population is overwhelmingly a lot. So they travel all over the planet, even in the ancient time. And they probably spread this belief, yeah? I never know about number 12 or 6 and 6 before until I went to Taiwan and they told me that, and I also do the same. Yes, and then one by one, you know, everybody believe in it, and it probably has some power.
Master, do you believe on that?
Well, I do, why not? I don't believe it when I have to give though, but if somebody give it to me. No, it's, why not? If you think positive about it, it's also your intention. It gives the power to that action and to that contain, whatever you have in there. Okay? Hmm. Even they make experience with dogs, you know, they give them just cardboard and a newspaper to eat, and they say, oh, it's very good, very good, and the dog eat also feel healthy. Don't try with your dogs, huh? I mean, those people, maybe they have power, positive, a long time already in their head, you see? My dogs, I feed very good food, though. Not cardboard and newspaper. Yes, they will know the difference. Even if I told them what, they know the difference. Oh, my dog's funny. Yeah, like happy, she loves food, yes. And she loves some certain kind of vegetarian ham in slice, small square like this, and then slice, a few slices in it. And she loves to eat that, just like that. And I cut it into half or square and then feed her until finished. If I go around in some country, it's difficult to buy these things, so we just eat whatever. And she doesn't like those new stuff. And then now and then, if I have some of this kind of slice of vegetarian ham, and she loves it. She eats the whole package. Okay, fine. And I don't have any more. Okay? So I throw the package in the garbage, of course, next to it. Next morning, she come back, look into the garbage. Take that package out, you know, the empty packet, go drop right in front of me. Do I need to translate into English? And then if I ignore it, I go somewhere else. Sometimes I don't feel like picking up and doing things. I have other things to do, more urgent. Then she go pick it up, follow me, and then drop it in front of wherever I sit again. Is that English or what kind of language? You know, even my assistant saw it, and she also understand. She's Chinese. She don't have to talk Chinese. we both laugh together. You know, I thought I don't have it anymore. Sorry. And then she feel like disappointed, and she just go somewhere else. Then I have to pick up the garbage, put back in the bag. Yeah, no need talk. Yeah, here in the world of human, we talk a lot and we misunderstand and we fight with each other. Dog, my dog don't need tell me anything. She just does it, you know. Or sometimes vegan cheese, you know, there's some slight vegan cheese that she loves, same stuff. If I don't have any more, then she goes smell at the fridge. And if she can't open it, then she go look into the garbage. Garbage bin, the open. I normally have just an open basket, no? And I throw things there, and then we room it up quick, you know, sometimes. But if there's only one empty packet, then I don't room it immediately. And then she go look into the basket, if any of them left over yesterday empty, and she would dig it out and give it to me. The message is so clear, huh? But because I don't have a lot of them. If here, then I can give her 2, 3, 4 packets to eat them all. Just for fun, like that, yeah? But in some country, don't have. Then she dig garbage and tell me that she want that thing. This girl is very funny. So if my dogs are fed, you know, cardboard and newspaper, I think she will know that. Don't try. Okay. Yeah? Good?
Yes.
Happy?
Yes.
Okay. Now we go into garden to meditate, okay? And I want to invite the Westerner to my house, my kitchen. I mean the non-moon face, flat nose, non-Asian. And the SMTV staff, okay? Asian or not, and can go to my kitchen now. I have a little cakes, not as many as yesterday. So whoever already eat something yesterday, please stand very far behind, okay? You can look, yeah? But you don't have to eat. Okay, see you soon, guys. And if you meditate in the garden, I will join you soon. You know why I invite the Westerner? Because they normally don't have the Asian cakes and cookies that we have. At home you have a lot. Even the Vietnamese know how to buy Chinese cookies. The Chinese, the Indonesian know how to buy Chinese cookies or Vietnamese cookies. Understand?
Yes.
The Westerner, they don't have much of choice. Yeah? Okay? The Western society, they still don't make a lot of vegan cookies yet. Not as good. Okay? Oh, don't be jealous, all right?
Yeah.
Love you. See you. Go and let them come, huh? Okay, huh? Yeah? All right. Sorry, the Taiwanese and the Vietnamese and the Chinese. It's all right?
Yeah.
You know? Generous. Yeah. Come join me, huh? Yeah, thank you. You're always young, huh?
Oh my God. Whenever I ask all the children already graduate from university or working or whatever, I can't believe it. I get it often. I don't even know. Yeah, because if they're children, I know them when they were, you know, babies. Now if they already graduated from university or doing some job already, then I mean I'm very old. So obvious, yeah? Come on, come back. Whoever should come with me and whoever go garden, yes, okay? It's cooler. Yeah, cool outside. Very natural air. Yes, I love you. I will go soon meditate with you. Oh, so much love. So much love, so much love. Okay.
Tune in to the next session of this international gathering with Supreme Master Ching Hai and our association members. To be notified when a new session is available, subscribe to Supreme Master Television's newsletter at www.suprememastertv.com/newsletter.
Supreme Master Ching Hai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For a free-of-charge guidance, please visit www.godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
Be vegan. Make peace. For more details, please visit www.suprememastertv.com.